at the Digital Insurance Agenda Amsterdam. I'm talking to Sentience, a Belgian company which takes raw data from mobile phones and makes it into very sensible stuff. It basically tracks and traces everybody. Now, this is a test phase. Look, all the people are at home, but it's getting 8 o'clock and they're disappearing. They're having all kinds of commute through transport, through public transport cars. They're going to work, they're going to a restaurant, they're going to the airport, to a health place. They know exactly where they are. Entertainment in the morning is not so much, but look how busy it is. Everybody basically flocks to work. Well, 2% is shopping and the home percentage goes down. So this is a test group where people have shown all over the world what they're doing. And this kind of information comes from Sentience. Now let's take a look. This is another dashboard that you can exactly see where on the world they are, how they hang along, and you can get statistics about them. Tom van der Doorn, how does this work?
So it's actually data science that at the input uses sensor data from smartphones, and then we apply machine learning to interpret sensor data into real-time context.
And how do you know that it's a health place or that they're home and that kind of stuff?
So there's a couple of things that we use. Underlying, we use location data, we use motion data, and then we have venue databases, point of interest databases, and activity modeling to know where people are, but also to know what they're doing. And then there's the behavioral mapping and routines that we use to interpret this at a truly, truly personal level.
So you basically help me, you give me data and you make sense out of it. And how do people get permission? I mean, they basically say, yes, you can track and trace me every time and you can know exactly what I'm doing?
So this kind of data sharing needs explicit permission. The way to get to explicit permission is our clients, because we don't do the data ourselves. Our clients within their mobile application say, listen, we're going to track your location in the background. We're going to track your activities because you will get something in return. And the thing you get in return is, because we know who you are, we understand your real-time context, we will actually adopt and even preempt what we'll provide to you as services, because we...
And you could basically do this for health insurance. You could say, hey, if you voluntarily allow to follow you, you could say about the health, how healthy my lifestyle is.
The healthy one is an interesting example, because you have all of these wearables that tell you like how well you sleep, heart rate level.
Yeah, but nobody's using them, but everybody has a mobile phone.
Because it's purely data without context. We can feed in the context that drives to people having poor or good sleep quality, high or low stress levels. And that's the power of context.
Yeah. And you can provide this kind of API. You can put this in your own app. And you can provide this for about a dollar a month for something, or dollar a... Yeah.
It's per active user, but the important thing is that we plug in into a client application. We charge on an active user basis. There's different flavors. It can go from...
It was about a euro and a year, I believe, huh?
It's per month. It's actually a euro per month for the full-fledged service. It can go down to 5 cents.
Okay, and it's how difficult is it to plug into an app? How much development time do I need?
The plugin is the easy bit. The SDK part is actually the easy bit. It's like a couple of hours of work, of integration work. The backend is a little bit more work. The backend on how you take the API or the data firehose into your application, or how it triggers your engagement with customers, that's the more challenging part.
What kind of other companies do you have? Customers.
Insurance being one of them. Insurance not just on the car side, but also on the home and the health side. Smart mobility, smart city. Loyalty and retail, it's still the same concept whereby you use insights into people's profile, lifestyle, and real-time context.
How many companies do you have now using your service?
We have about 20, but they're all global companies, large companies, so the customer base behind this is in the multi-millions.
How many people in the company?
45, majority of them data scientists, data engineers.
Okay, located in?
Antwerp, Belgium.
Hey, the Belgians do it better. A beautiful way to show. Can you just imagine that you know this about your customers and what you can do with that, if they allow you to do that? But of course, if you make it interesting for them, they will do it. Innovation from Belgium.